All right, so the next one is the greater good. This one, I think, starts to remind us just a wee bit about hesitation marks. Like, it's kind of, because it's got this woodblocky marimba-y sound in it that I feel like we heard a lot of in hesitation marks. The theory of the song tells the assimilation of people into believing. The theory of the song tells the assimilation of people. Okay, I'm not sure I understand the sentence, but I think they're trying to say this is about people being assimilated into a belief system where they're following the government of year zero. They are now part of the greater good. Breathe us in slowly. Everything you do, everywhere you go, anything we want, anything. So that repeats over and over again while breathe us in slowly. And then apparently there's a part where he says persuasion, coercion, submission, assimilation. Starts out pretty slow and sparse. I remember that. On headphones. Tip. Thank you. Yes. Okay. Yeah, this is a really interesting track that probably gets overlooked a lot. So there's a drum loop that goes the entire time pretty much without fail. There's one moment it kind of drops out, but just kind of there. I feel like it's a really like laid back beat. It's kind of, what's this remind you all of? A little bit of hip hop, a little hip hoppy, maybe trip hoppy. But still, it's kind of fat though. It's not super minimal. I mean, it is minimal, but it's the sounds themselves are kind of like fat and in your face. And it's also much cleaner. It's not crushed to death, you know, with distortion and who is it? Ren? So this album sounds like it's trying to delete itself. Or was that Sam? Ren, an album that always sounds like it's trying to delete itself. Yeah. So this drum groove doesn't have that feeling to me. It's just kind of clean and dry and just right there. A lot of space. Right. So the hi-hat drops out a lot. Oops. So it's a little bit, now that I listen to it a little bit more, sometimes it almost sounds a little bit marchy or military-like, just slightly. So that's kind of lulling us, I think, in the background. Now the bass is awesome. It sounds so good on headphones, my God. So this one definitely sounds like Year Zero, right? It's got... it's being crushed. It's being distorted. Kind of always evolving and changing, right? So that's kind of looping. That's just on D. It's hanging out on D. One of the things I like about the song is that it's it does have a tonal center, but a lot of the tonal elements of the song sound as if they are doing whatever the fuck they want in any key they desire. So it's sort of like a tonal but atonal song. So in D, so this bass is just on D. Okay. Now there's definitely some classical stuff going on, and here's a track that says classical. So let's listen to that soloed. Oh, I want to know what that used to sound like. So they made this terrifying thing. I don't know what it used to be exactly, but I feel like I'm hearing a clarinet, I think. Maybe an oboe? No, it's clarinet. Da-da. So those pitches are a little disconcerting. That's the fifth, but then it goes down a half step. And that's a very destabilizing sound. So it's just like... makes this feel... That's the flat five you hear in metal a lot, right? So. And then this... I guess maybe, I don't know what that used to be. It could be so many things playing that note and then it being completely mangled. Maybe a piccolo or a flute. It's kind of like a mosquito a little bit. I've got another classical line here. Oh, this one. So tonally, what is that? Oh, the second. So that would fit really well into D minor, and it does have that sound to me. Like, it sounds kind of dark and sad. That's the ninth. And then on top of that, we have... Sounds so Trent-y. So that's kind of going... oboe, maybe? Just those... Just that right there could be in a film score. Tension, little release. It's nice. So that goes throughout, and then okay, I always thought that was a harp, but now doesn't it sound like a piano, Travis? So I don't know, again, it's probably just like one line, maybe a chromatic run, and they just pitched it down over and over again. It's super dreamy though. It's like, oh, and that really well mimics the sound of the doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Okay, here's something that says harp. So I'm guessing this is, yes. Oh man. That's so lost and creepy. I love that. So one of the things that makes that sound so weird and dreamy is that all of that, this figure is then repeated a whole step up and then another whole step up. And if you have enough things consecutively moving only in whole steps, you start to sound like you've lost your place, because in most music, things move up by whole steps and then half steps. There's like a balance, and it just, this is so many whole steps, and it's not sticking in a scale or anything. It's just, yeah, it starts to sound like the whole tone scale. Totally. Super dreamy. So if you only move up by whole steps, it'll sound like a creepy film score. All right, let's see if it changes. It does. That is the fucking ugliest harp line I've ever heard in my life. It sounds so good in the song. I mean, it's just totally atonal. It's so... I wouldn't know how to come up with that. I'm just so impressed. It's like... But I love it! Ugh. Well, I will study that more later for my own edification, because wow. So we got the breathe vox, all right.
Breathe. Ascend. Slowly. Slowly. Breathe. Ascend. Slowly.
Oh, it's a prepared piano. This is so avant-garde and contemporary. Dude's a composer. This is like a bell. So rhythmic. This also doesn't sound like it belongs in this key. Oh, wait. Okay, well, it's flat against whatever I'm playing, but. The prepared piano sound, it really takes away the strong fundamental frequency, so it starts to sound like it's a lot of resonance, and it starts to blur the line of, like, what note is this? So it starts to sound more, like metallic and like a sound instead of a musical note. But if you play it on the piano, it actually is really pretty. You totally would hear that in a Nine Inch Nails song. Okay, Oh, and this confirms my suspicion. At the end, it sounded like a sine wave, but that keeps going out of, like, phase with itself, like two oscillators, maybe, and, like, you can hear when it the two line up completely perfectly because it just smooths out and then it starts to do the aural beating. So that's on D. Ooh. This might be too nerdy. I don't know exactly what I'm looking for. I thought maybe I could like see something. Never mind. I want to find the part where he says persuasion, assimilation, though, because that always gets a little lost. Maybe it's this part? Oh yeah, okay, wait.
Everything you do, everywhere you go, anything we want, anything. Everything you do, everywhere you go, anything we want, anything. Persuasion, coercion.
So he's singing. Cool. All right. Well, I'm going to spend more time with that song at some point for me, but I'll move on because I'm assuming not everyone is into it the way I am. Dreamhouse vibes. Yes. Ren, have you been to the Dreamhouse? We talk about this. It's like an unforgettable moment in my life, going to the Dreamhouse in Manhattan. Lamont Young and something Zazila. Catherine? Martha? Mary? Mary Zazila? It's just like all the prime number fundamental frequencies in sine waves. Just forever. Forever and ever and ever with purple lights, and it makes you feel like you have no idea where you are, when you are, why. It's so cool.